Prelude of Middlemarch begins with a brief recap of the epic life of Saint Teresa, a 16th century Spanish mystic who found her calling in the reform of a religious community of nuns. Other such heroines are still being born, but they'll never find the living stream of fellowship with like-minded world movers. Book one is called Miss Brooke. In chapter one, Dorothea Brooke is a 19-year-old orphan who's recently come to live, along with her younger sister Celia, at Tipton Grange, an estate owned by their bachelor uncle, Arthur Brooke. The two girls are heiresses with 700 pounds apiece. Dorothea is exceptionally beautiful, intelligent, and passionate about God. Celia asks Dorothea to divide their dead mother's jewelry. Dorothea gives most of the ornaments to Celia, keeping for herself only a ring and bracelet of emeralds. In chapter two, Sir James Chetham, a young baronet of the nearby estate of Freshet Hall, and Reverend Edward Casaubon, a scholarly clergyman in his late 40s, come to dinner. Sir James is courting Dorothea, whom he admires for her beauty and intelligence. But she is trying to pay attention to the new Mr. Casaubon, whom she's immediately attracted to as a learned and distinguished looking man she can connect with spiritually. In chapter three, Mr. Casaubon is working on his magnum opus, a book that will prove all religions and systems of spiritual thought in the world are corrupted versions of an original, revealed tradition reflected in the Bible. Dorothea imagines herself as his helpmate, sharing the life of the mind. Meanwhile, Sir James continues to court her. Dorothea obstinately believes Sir James is interested in Celia. Celia understands his intentions, but isn't sure her sister will turn him down. The prelude compares Dorothea Brooke to a saint, a parallel threaded throughout the novel. Dorothea has the saint's passion, but is prevented from leading an epic life in a world that lacks a communal vision. The fragmented life created by the Industrial Revolution is reflected in the narrator's doubts that there is the possibility of living an epic and reformed life. Middlemarch takes place during a period of great change and upheaval in England. George Eliot's omniscient narrator has the persona of a wise sage, someone with deep understanding of human nature and a godlike compassion for the flaws and blind spots of humanity.